Today we're going to create an awesome RGB split transition that you can use from now on in any project that you would like. It fits on any timeline, frame rate and resolution, and it's fully customizable. And make sure to stick to the end because I'm going to give you a bonus tip there. So first of all, in order to create that RGB split transition, we're going to go to our effects library in the top left corner, then go to video transitions and then scroll down until you see fusion transitions and then grab the fusion cross dissolve and put it in between the middle of your two clips. Then right click on that transition and open in fusion page, which will bring up this cross dissolve in the fusion page. First of all, I'm going to make a little more space. So I'm going to bring that over to the right and then move that over to the left. And what I'm going to be doing now is I'm going to right click on that cross dissolve group and select ungroup. And as you can see, there's not much going on. It's just a simple dissolve node. But then we need three channels. We need the red channel, the green channel, and the blue channel individually to create the RGB split effect. But how do we get each channel individually? You can do that by using a channel boolean node. And if you don't know where to find the channel boolean node, just go up in the toolbar right next to your merge node is the channel booleans node, and then grab this and put it onto your node editor. And of course we need the red channel, the green channel and the blue channel. So we need three of those channel boolean nodes, something like that. And first of all, I'm going to rename them to stay a little bit more organized. So right click on them, go to rename or hit F2 on your keyboard and call this red channel. Then that one is the green channel. And this one's gonna be our blue channel. Voila. Now we have the red, the green, and the blue channel, but we have not changed any settings yet. So starting out with the red channel, go to the red channel and go to the inspector in the top right corner. If that's not already open, just give it a click. Operation mode copy is fine. The red channel, red foreground is good. Then green, and change the green foreground to black, and then change the blue foreground to black as well. Then go over to the green channel, leave the operation mode as is, change the red channel from red foreground to black, change the green channel from green foreground to green background, and then change the blue channel from blue foreground to black. Then go over to the blue channel, leave the operation mode as is, change the red channel from red foreground to black, change the green channel from green foreground to black, and then change the blue channel from blue foreground to blue background. So right now we have created our individual channels, but we can't see anything yet. If I'm gonna highlight my red node and hit one on my keyboard, you can see in the left viewer nothing has changed. And that's because we have to connect all of those individual channels into this node tree. We're gonna do that by going to our dissolve one output, grab the output of dissolve one and connect it into each of those yellow inputs. And as you can see, if I'm connecting the red channel, you can see the red channel in the left viewer. Then I'm gonna go to my green channel, hit one on my keyboard, gonna go to the output of dissolve one and connect it into the yellow input of the green channel, which will then give us the green channel. Now go over to my blue channel, hit one on my keyboard, go over to the dissolve one output and connect the output of dissolve one to the yellow input of the blue channel. And as you can see, we now have the blue channel. But in order to create the RGB split effect, we have to move each of those channels against each other. But first of all, we have to mix those channels back together so that they will ultimately lead back to this original image. And we're gonna do that by using two more channel boolean nodes. So grab another channel boolean node, put that on the node editor and another one. And now we have to make only one change to each of those channel boolean nodes, and that is to select them, go to the inspector in the top right corner, and change the operation mode from copy to add. We're gonna do that in the next channel boolean node as well. Change the operation mode from copy to add. Right now we have to connect them back together. So grab the output of the red channel and connect it into the yellow input of the channel boolean number one. Then take the output of the green channel and connect it into the green input of channel boolean number one. But what happens if we mix red and green? Well, that gives you yellow, right? So go to the channel boolean number one, hit one on your keyboard, and if that's yellow, you've done everything right so far. Congratulations. But now we have to mix in that blue channel. And we're gonna do that by first of all going into the channel boolean number one, connecting the output into the yellow input of the next channel boolean. Then go to our blue channel and grab the output and connect it into the green input of channel boolean number two. And what happens if you mix those three channels together? Well, basically nothing, it just is the original image. So go to channel boolean number two, hit one on your keyboard, and if you see the original image, again, you've done everything right. So far, so good. Let's go to the output of channel boolean number 2 and close this node tree by grabbing the output and connecting it into the yellow input of media out. And voila, we have connected everything here into this whole node tree. But now we have to move those channels against each other. And we're gonna do that by using a simple transform node. But first of all, let's get a little bit more organized, and we're gonna do that by using pipe routers. Pipe routers are a very handy tool to stay organized on a more complex node tree, but it's very good to get in the habit, even on such small node trees, to just stay more organized during your compositions. So go to this line right here, hold Option or Alt on your keyboard and make a left click to create a pipe router. And then again, do this with the green channel as well. Create a pipe router, something like that. And one quick little bonus tip, you can also create pipe routers with multiple outputs. Just hover with your mouse over those three outputs on the dissolve one node until they all change color, then hold Option or Alt on your keyboard, make a left click to create another pipe router, just like so. And right now, everything's just a little bit more organized, and we can start working from there. So as I said, we're gonna move those channels against each other by using simple transform nodes. Go to the red channel and then grab a transform node from the toolbar right here. So with this transform one selected, let's go to the inspector, and if we move the center part X just a little bit towards the left and the right, we can actually see that the RGB split is happening. And just for demonstration purposes, if I'm gonna drag that all the way to the right, you can see that we have a harsh edge right here, and that's totally not what we wanna have. So first of all, go to Edges, up in the Transform node, change that from Canvas to Mirror, and right now, this is just so much better looking. What I'm gonna be doing then is, first of all, I'm gonna reset my center part, then I'm gonna right click on that, and then I'm gonna go to Modify With, and then Vector Result. Then once you selected Vector Result, you can actually see that it's created a keyframe. But what this keyframe does is it makes us accessible to the Modifiers tab next to Tools under Transform 1. So click the Modifiers tab, and right now you have Vector on Transform 1 Center. And right now you have this Distance slider, and if I'm gonna choose the Distance slider a little bit towards the left or the right, you can see that I'm creating this RGB split effect. But I don't wanna keyframe this distance slider. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna reset that, right click on that, go to Modify With, Anim Curves. And right now you have all those crazy options. First of all, we're gonna change our curve because we don't want our transition to be linear. We want our transition to be easing. So let's change that to easing, and then change the in and out easing animation from none to exponential. And then one key part about that transition, or every transition in general, is that you have to select mirror. If you don't check mirror, your transition will just go from the first frame all the way up towards the end. And your like effect of the transition is fully visible on the last frame of the transition. And that's not what we want. But if we check mirror, our transition will just start with no effect at all. And then in the middle part, we have the effect fully visible. And then if we go more towards the end, our effect disappears, just like you want your transition to be. So then under scaling, we want to change our scale. So let's go to the middle part around frame 12 and then drag down the scale to around -0.013. Then what we want to do is go to transform one, hit Command or Control C to copy this, select the green channel and hit Command or Control V to paste that transform in. Then of course we want to go back into our modifiers, into our NM curves modifiers, and we want to change the scale to 0. So once we've changed our scale back to 0, just copy that transform node once again, Command or Control C, go to the blue channel and paste it one more time, Command or Control V. And then with this transform selected, again, we're gonna go to our modifiers tab, go to NM curves and reset our scale. And using the scale slider, just bring that down just a little more until 0.00 something. So right now we have a red and teal RGB split, but if I'm gonna bring that up just a little bit more, you can actually see we have teal, yellow, blue, pink, and red. And if I'm gonna use that slider, you can create like any RGB split effect that you want. Let's just go with something like that. That's looking pretty good to me. And if you want to save this transition as a preset, you totally can do that. Just right click on that, go to Create Transition Preset, and then let's just call this RGB Split 2, and then all you want to do is hit OK. And then in your effects library under video transition under user, you have the RGB split 2. So what you can now do is just delete that transition, go to your user transitions, use the RGB split 2, put it in between the two clips, and voila, you have your RGB split transition. And as I promised, here is the bonus tip. You can also use that transition just as a simple effect. For example, like right here where this dude crosses his arms, I'm gonna make a cut, and then I'm gonna use the RGB split 2 transition that we just created, drag that in between, and hit play. And we have a RGB split effect whilst the dude is crossing his arms. And again, we can make that transition as long as we want or as short as we want. So that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a comment, especially if you learned something new today. But with that being said, hope you all have a great day. See you next time. Bye.